Welcome to Obscene Podzine. This episode is all about
shredding the Wignar, brah.
We are the 99% of rock and roll.
Don't take us serious here at Obscene.
Yes. So Frankie
has transformed into a guest because he is not here. Instead, he has shed his skin like a snake and he has become someone else. That's the power we have here at Obscene Podzine. Would you like to tell us who you are and what organizations you are affiliated with? Shalom, Mr. FBI.
I'm actually dead. I'm dead. I'm the figment of all of your guys' imaginations.
Whoa, bro. This
kind of goes with the territory. We're used to a lot of imagination figments around here.
And guys, don't do drugs or you'll end up like these two guys.
It's true.
That is true. We tell them that every episode, and yet they continue to snort marijuana.
I can't believe it. Okay, so guys, I'm Blake. I'm the ultimate Wignat, I guess. Woo! I traveled the seven seas to go find random white guys that can rap. And today it's going to be full of weird music because that's the Obscene way, right?
That Absolutely. Is the Obscene way. See, we're all Bernie bros here at Obscene Podzine. What the fuck's a Wignat? Can you describe to us what a Wignat is?
Wigger nationalism, whoop whoop.
So is that just like the Kid Rock version of democratic national socialism?
Exactly.
It'd be a lot cooler if you did.
All right, I think I can get the hang of this whole Wignat deal. It sounds you know, diverse and multicultural. I like it.
It is very multicultural. The issue is sometimes the people like to culturally appropriate.
Yeah,
things happen. Do you know what we do when people try to culturally appropriate around here?
We ask them politely yet firmly to leave.
It's true. Yes.
So we're gonna let you pick the music today. So why don't you throw one at us?
Okay. So since I did the whole whoop whoop thing, why not Twisted We Don't Die?
Well, what's that again?
Twisted. Yes.
I am familiar with this one, and fucking Twisted is, that's some cool shit. I remember this from like third grade, bro.
What was the
Twisted was my introduction into Wignat society.
Wow.
What was the name of the song?
We Don't Die. We might as well go to their classic hits when they were still affiliated with ICP, right?
They're not affiliated. They're not ICP guys no more.
Nope, they're off doing their own thing, magic ninja shit.
Oh, these guys are affiliated with ICP?
They used to be,
Yeah.
Huh, that's a interesting cult there. Nice.
I always liked them better than ICP.
Same.
Yeah, I wish we could draw crowds like the
or have that kind of fan base.
Yeah.
Let's be honest, for two dropouts, you can't complain what they did with their lives.
Yeah, it's good marketing.
I know. It's like, why not get all the, like, build a cult around the right side?
If only Hitler had the fucking marketing genius of ICP.
Yeah, or the I don't know, they're kind of just as oppressed as Hitler.
Oh yeah. People don't like juggalos.
Maybe Nazis and juggalos should unite.
Yeah, we're good friends with Bernie. We'll come up with something, some kind of Bernie campaign to unite juggalos and Nazis to vote Bern 2027. Yeah, babe.
Yep.
No, dude. Okay, so in this way, bro, the few Bernie bros I think were actually
trans for the race. Of course they are. They're all white. They're all white males who are down with Democratic National Socialism. And together, we are going to change the world.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Bernie Sanders and Popsy Podsy.
You gotta tell Bernie and start promoting himself a little bit heavier, though. Serial killers, we don't
die. Freaks of the night, we don't die. Yeah, so was that one of the ICP guys in the video? What's his name?
Yeah,
it was
Violent J.
Yep.
Yeah, this song came out when you guys were probably enough to record.
Yeah, dude, that's about when I seen him, was 99, 2000, somewhere around there is when I saw this video on, I think it was, the network was The Box. It was what us privileged white kids got when we didn't have cable. Couldn't have access to MTV.
Wasn't The Box, didn't they show a Saturday Night cartoons and stuff, or Saturday Morning cartoons?
I'm not sure. The Box I'm familiar with was just music videos all day, and this is by the time when MTV had all them gay-ass shows. Started all their little reality or non-reality nonsense.
I'm lucky that I was never really around for it. Like, the last, like, gasping breath of MTV was, like, this story.
Jersey Shore. Hey, do you know what these guys have in common with Ted Nugent? Is both of them think they're not going to die. I mean, go ahead and listen to Stranglehold and Ted Nugent. it very clear.
Detroit too. So I'm gonna on you guys. These were the guys that opened up for the show that Eminem and ICP started beefing over. Hmm. We all know that. So these were like Eminem's first concert openers.
Huh. Oh yeah. I don't know if Yellow Wolf's on your list, but I've been a big fan of Yellow Wolf.
Yeah, Yellow Wolf Pop the Trunk is always a classic.
Yes! Fucking love that song so much. Hey, do we have any kind of news to talk about before we jump into more stuff there, Arnold?
Yeah, hit me with that.
I don't. Oh, yeah, you don't. Guys, I gotta admit to the Obsceners, I fucked up. I don't have my file with my badass drops. You're gonna have to deal with, you know, the old school Podzine drops. You know, I know it's a shame, but
well,
next time.
Well, okay. So here's a little something. I'm not even gonna really read this article, but it's going around. Roman Polanski is suing the Motion Picture Academy over expelling him.
Oh, I hope he wins.
Like, yeah, y'all are bigoted against rapists, man. And this is
that is a sexual orientation, isn't it?
Yeah, that
the whole thing is that Mark Weinstein and the other dude in a room together. Whoever wins can be Hollywood.
Yeah, you're sounding a bit robotic there, but we noticed you mentioned Weinstein, which
I heard
we've done
Weinstein.
Several. Yeah, we've done several Weinstein episodes, that's for sure.
Yeah, he just keeps...
Have Weinstein and the other guy fight, and whoever wins can be accepted back into the Academy.
Yeah, a rape fight.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, rape fight, bro. We can capitalize on that. That's Wignat as fuck, dude. Yeah. Okay, that's how we. That's how we handle things in Bernie's Democratic National Socialist America.
Yes.
We listen to ICP and let and commence with the rape fighting. So.
Yeah. Oh God.
We line up the ring with ficuses.
Who can jerk off into the most ficuses? That's stage one. It's a three stage trial. Trial by rape. Man.
Yeah. Oh God.
Yeah, the ancient Greek way. What was that? Robots.
I said this certainly took a disturbing route. God damn it.
Yep.
Now you listen to me, mister.
It's true. Yeah. Yep. So robot rape. Is there anything else here? There's, I don't know. News is getting more and more boring.
It is. Come on, Trump, fucking tweet some pussy grabbing shit again. Come on.
Yeah, right.
Grab him by the pussy.
Yeah.
Right. Which we have a song about on telepathicsandwich.com. It's called Grab 'em.
Yeah. Off of our album, The Wall. Free album, The Wall.
But y'all should pay the shekels. Big shekels.
You should. You should. But let me see here. Beyonce has a $60 million Netflix deal because they're apparently trying to give black women more money these days. So that's cool. We don't have a $60 million Netflix deal, though we could use
privilege. I'll accept the $30 million one. I ain't expensive.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Hey, even 10. I'll take a $10 million deal. You can Jew me down to 10.
Yeah, I'll take a $10 deal. I believe I believe Obscene started with, $17 or something?
17.
17.
Million? Dollars. Also, so they're making a movie about the only African samurai in history, just because, you know, well, we was kings and whatnot.
Oh yeah, what they were all jealous of Tom Cruise, you know?
Yeah, right. Just what's this white guy doing? Why does this white man get to be a samurai? No black man get to be a samurai. Shit.
Oh shit! Let's do Pop the Trunk. This new shit's boring.
Yep.
Yeah, I listen, like, my buddy gave me a CD, the last CD, and I'm like, buddy, I don't enjoy it. It's not very...
We've already listened to Pop the Trunk on a previous show, haven't we?
Yeah.
So acoustic? let's not be redundant. Let's try that acoustic one. See how gay it is.
I stand in line.
People's here. Park. That's very Democratic National Socialist, man.
It is. It's the People's Park.
Yeah. Not your corporate overlord's park. The people's.
Yeah, it belongs to net taxpayers, right? That's what it means by people's? Or is that just some libertarian Spurg nonsense?
What?
What?
Whoa, man. What's an economy?
This used to be my company.
Yep.
Used to be all our company, man.
Yep, part native, complete. You know.
Whether they want to admit it or not.
Wignat enough.
We are a very multicultural people here.
It's true.
We are. This is America.
Yeah, you can be any kind of white you want here, buddy.
Yeah, you can. You can.
You can even be a Wignat.
You could be a straight up Nazi and be black as black can be. It's truly a beautiful country.
We are truly accepting anyone, any color, any style.
Oh yes.
Literally, like, dude, where are you going? I'm out.
Are you gonna like play the song, man?
Yeah, what the fuck, bro?
Or just go there. I'm gonna skip to over all his. All right. Damn it.
By January 1st, I was.
It just leads in.
Yeah, of course it does.
Alabama, and then out to Seattle, Washington, to get on a boat to make money.
I want to get on a boat in Seattle, Washington.
I tried. I applied to be a crab fisherman a couple times.
Really? How'd you fail, man?
It's good money. Good white job. I just, I don't know. I've never been on a fucking boat before, so I guess.
They're like those goddamn Midwesterners.
Yeah, I mean, I'll cruise around, go water skiing and fucking Lake Michigan and shit, but
there's a little slight difference to going out into the ocean.
The Bering Strait?
Yeah. You better listen what he's
saying, punk. Don't make that's an SM, SM7B right there, or SM7, the original.
So are you still trying to do the whole Northwest Front thing? I mean, it's the most Bernie-ish of all the areas.
We gotta take it back. We gotta liberate the Northwest Front from Antifa terrorists. One Bernie bra at a time.
Yeah, right.
Well, in all honesty, I found that Bernie Bros will accept the nationalist path a lot easier than right-wing people.
It's kind of funny how that works, yeah.
Well, I mean, if you read Mein Kampf, it's basically you could hand it to any Bernie bro and put his face on the cover and they'd be like totally down, so.
Yeah, just, dude, now that's, if you want to do some epic trolling, IRL trolling, bro. Just print off a bunch of copies of Mein Kampf and put Bernie Sanders' face on it and my struggle. Bernie Sanders, my struggle. And just start passing it out on college campuses. Just nothing changed.
Call it My Awakening by Bernie Sanders.
I just changed the word Jew to 1%. German to...
Oh, dude, could you imagine us building our own army of beefsteaks? You know what beefsteaks are, right?
Enlighten us, please.
Oh, brown on the outside, red on the inside.
Yes.
Jazzball.
Goddamn commies.
Yep.
They got good rhetoric. I'll give them that.
Yep.
Yeah. They know how to make a convincing argument, mostly by emotions.
Yep,
I'm all right with the Nazballs, man. Like until the night of long knives, we peeps.
Yep.
We got a lot of centrists. We gotta go after. You know.
Yeah, exactly.
Goddamn. Right-wing centrists, like slightly right-wing centrists, seem to be the worst people to ever deal with and have a political conversation.
Yeah, I know, and I call them commies, and they don't like that. That's pretty much what it is.
Yeah, it's kind of funny. Yeah, it's that old it's like the boomer right.
Yeah.
Even if the people themselves aren't boomers, they're how do you say, spiritual boomers?
I gotta say, you know,
yeah,
I gotta say that acoustic was Pop the Trunk was pretty lame. I mean, I like the piano part, but come on, you could have added a dude with a cajon or a shaker. There should have been something else.
There should have been percussion. Even if you just had some like Jamal beatboxing in the corner, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
I definitely prefer the original. One time when I was just adding random songs to my phone, I downloaded that one, and it was kind of a letdown. Yellow Wolf has really, really good songs and really, really bad songs. He's kind of like A-Stack.
I can get down with that. There's I got into him and I nerded out on him for a while and loved a lot of it, but some of it I'm like, eh.
Yeah, there's a lot of good songs, and there's not any like mediocre songs that Yellow Wolf does. They're either really, really good or really, really bad.
Hey, that's kind of like Butthole Surfers.
Yeah, it's really not a bad way to go, you know?
Yeah.
That way... There's nothing worse than boring. I'd rather have hate half of your songs than think you're just boring.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Like when I put on any, I don't know, half of Rush's albums, I can say, okay, yeah, this is decent Rush here, but I'm bored.
Yeah, we should do a request. I don't know how many do we have today.
We don't have too many, but we're gonna start out here because on the Telegram group, on the Telegram, our friendly request robot, we have a message here from Masked Magician.
One of our benefactors,
our original, the OGs.
Yeah, the OG, the guy who made this all possible. Yeah,
he basically owns about the majority of the last year of Obscene. So let's hear what he has to say.
Good morning, Obscene Podscene. This is Masked Magician. I'd like to request a song, I'm Not an Addict by... Fuck, I don't remember. All right, that's all.
Very eloquent. Let's see what we got here. While you find it, we can listen to some good music. You find it? Yep.
All right, so... There is a Jane's Addiction.
Ew!
For a song that is called I'm Not an Addict, or at least that comes up here, but I think this is the one that comes up the most, so.
I hope so, yeah.
Hopefully this is the right one, buddy.
Yeah, if you wanted Jane's Addiction, Masked Magician, you should have caught our vocalist episode where we expose Peripheral
his Zionist plans of world domination.
For being the
Jewish, nigger-loving, hippie bullshit
that he is.
It's true. And he invented Lollapalooza.
I never liked his music.
It's terrible.
Other than, like, Bing Crosby. I like one song from him.
It's terrible. Terrible band.
Yeah, and he's the worst member of that band, and that's saying something, because what's his name? Dave Navarro was a terrible guitarist.
Faggot. Yeah, big time.
I remember him from all those VH1 documentaries.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure they were all, I'm sure, you know, because he knew somebody. Oh, God.
Yeah.
Hey, I used to listen to this song all the time.
Oh, is this Cranberries chick or some shit?
It sounds like it. I never really thought about it. It was just one of those songs I just played when it was on music.
Yeah, when I looked this song up, right under it was Zombie.
Yeah, I seen that.
Hayes Choice. Let me look that up.
Yeah, look that up. See if that's one of that bitch's side project or something. Did she die? That chick?
Yeah, she died after she complained about Trump.
See? See what happens?
Trump is having people laugh. Okay, so there was this black guy that I'm talking about. He's like, Trump was our first true black president. He's like, look at how that motherfucker carries himself. Now he speaks. I'm like, I cannot argue with you. It's not a
cool. Yep. I feel
alive. Nope, these guys black are Belgian.
Ah.
So it was probably like the when all those European bands started invading. In the mid-90s. After the Yankees came out of the whole
Oh, Jam, what are you sniffing at, boy?
I like that drum sound. Nothing fancy to it. It's solid.
Yeah, you just described the 90s.
Yep. Yeah, the mix in general is 90s as hell, and kind of looks like Ellen.
Ah, she's even doing that gay little dance.
Yeah, it was the dance that did it. I saw the dance and the hair just...
Looking back, like, all the chicks that, like, try dressing like they're in the 90s now are all, like, lesbians. And that was always the aesthetic I was attracted to. So it's awkward hitting on women nowadays.
Yeah, right.
It's like, you dress like you're still part of a grunge band. What's up, ladies? Oh, you don't like Nick. This is awkward.
Yeah, that's unfortunate.
Lesbianism doesn't exist. All bitches like dick. You just gotta, you know, show them. You just gotta show them what's up.
So I'm going to turn since we're going wig nasty on this shit.
Wig nasty, yeah. I think you made a request with that, so we'll have to do that next.
We gotta do that.
I do. This is the cool part.
What?
This cool little Tom part. It didn't resolve very well, though.
Yeah, I was about to say that. It should have...
Of course it could have been used
more effectively.
Of course they didn't. We got some fucking Ellen bitch leading your band. You're going to resolve like a faggot. It's just how it is.
I don't believe you. You're addicted to, you know, that sweet strange. Carpet munching.
Yeah.
It's like the high end volleyball.
What was that?
I miss when those kids were cool. What?
Huh?
What?
Damn!
So apparently this episode I can't hear either.
Yeah, well, you're on a phone. I mean, we apologize, Podzeners. Maybe you should go donate to Blake's organization so he can get himself a fucking microphone and like a computer or something.
I'm actually taking donations because I do really just have a notebook. Hey. And it's fucking annoying to use.
Hey, sit down, boy! Sorry, my dog's about to fuck up my rig. I'm in the mobile rig, so this can be disastrous if he knocks this shit over.
Yeah, right.
He's a man-eater. Don't worry.
No, he is a man-eater. This is why no niggers are going to bust into my camper, because I'm armed with two vicious man-eaters and rifles. So, come on, Antifa.
You're probably more worried about meth heads where you are, though.
I'm in the wilderness upon a mountaintop, and of course meth heads are around, but hey, they my niggas, you know what I mean?
Well, you gotta become one with the meth heads, you know, read Siege and smoke meth and all that good stuff.
They're Bernie bros, just faster.
Yeah, just like Charlie Manson.
Hey, don't worry, the SS was on a lot of meth when they're doing the Blitzkriegs. Okay, guys.
It's true. Yeah.
Let's play his request. Can you find that in the Telegram group? Which you all should join at t.me/something or another. What was it?
t.me/obscene. Very hard to remember.
Yeah. I ask Arnold every episode, but I also do a lot of drugs and vote Bernie Sanders, so you know that's kind of the thing.
I've learned. Let us just embrace the downfall. You know, let's follow.
Yeah, pretty much. It's the fall of Rome again. So you may as well just have an orgy or two. I mean, All right. Before we get to that, I'm gonna go through. I want to do this in order. There's some audio stuff in here. From the record club group. So.
Oh, yeah. We were going to play some of that
people,
shit.
They got zombie pigment in vats. And the globalists have a conspiracy to take over the nether. Over at CERN, they got a nether portal made out of obsidian. In their secret underground lab in the middle of Antarctica, They got the end portal. They're trying to bring the Ender Dragon into the real world using DMT and lots of bone meal.
Whoa, man, that's crazy. Hey, Jamie, can you pull that up?
Type in, Ender Dragon DMT.
Yeah, well, it sees that the first thing that comes up is Minecraft porn. And right next to that is Infowars.com. So, Alex, what are you doing, man?
Well, you see, ever since my life, the pills haven't been working the way they used to, and my Ultra Male Vitality is not working anymore, so I gotta supplement it with some porn. In specific, Minecraft porn.
So this is the kind of fun you can have in the Telegram group if you join, and we do not discriminate, okay?
No, all are welcome. We are furry friendly. If you're a furry, if you're a wignat, if you're a furry wignat, we don't care.
What about jigaboos? Are jigaboos allowed?
There are finest folk.
Only tranny jigaboos. Only tranny jigaboos, but okay. We can make an exception here or there. I don't think we have any of those darkies yet. But you're welcome to join, and Irish too. I don't know about Irish in there.
Well, even the Irish can. Dude, Frankie, this is just way too diverse.
Frankie T is an Irish Mormon, so
and he's not in there, and I don't know if we're gonna let him. We haven't.
We might have to be a Frankie free chat there.
We have to consult with the elders, the Council of Elders on that one, the learned elders of Hobbiton.
Let me talk to these people because I'm going to tell them no Irish allowed.
One does not simply talk to the learned elders of Hobbiton.
Oh yeah. So another thing in the whole headlines deal, that was what spurred that Alex Jones rant in the group. But, they just learned scientists have discovered how to reanimate dead pig brain tissue in dead pigs. So we're going to have some zombie pigs very soon. And frankly, this could not come at a better time for the world. I think this is exactly what the collapse needs.
Well, let me tell you something. We're Bernie Bros now, and Democratic National Socialism is the way to go. And we have to give these zombie piglets votes. Okay, it is not right that they do not get to vote. Okay, and we're going to do something about it.
How could you let these things be unrepresented?
Yes, it's true.
Very true.
Society is family needs pigs. What?
Whoa. Let me see here. All right, where was what am I looking for here?
You're looking for Blake's request in the Telegram group.
Which what? Where was
Wig
that?
Nasty, yo.
Wig Nasty, nigga.
Wig Nasty. Is that posted up in there? What song is it?
Any of them? They're all pretty. Actually, they're actually all pretty good.
Just run your random algorithm .exe.
All right, this does not seem to be coming up on there. I know it was there was a track.
He posted it. You can play it right from the Telegram group.
Yeah, that's why I'm trying to find it though. There's just so much shit in there. People keep posting stuff because it'd be cool. Yeah,
Normal protocol for Telegram requests, just so everyone's aware, is to hit up the friendly robot.
Yep. DM the Podzine request line in there.
There you go.
Well, if you join the t.me/obzine, record club, there'll be a pinned message up at the top, which will tell you how to hit up the who to hit up, and that the robot will take your requests and hang loose, bro.
Who to hit up? How to get up, nigga? What's up? Yeah, dude, this is some old school shit. I like it. some. It's got that murder was the case that they gave me fucking a little period.
Oh yeah, it's good stuff. That's come around. Beat the war drum,
come and get some. Where the nice hard drop. Unless that was an internet thing. All around my town. When
the hell these new wig that's come around. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Bro, I hope your vocals come in better in the recording here. I'll tell you that one.
They probably won't. I know how those recordings go. It's usually, I don't know, sometimes it's a little bit better during a song.
That's really what it is I can't hear him during the song. I don't know if it's a ducking thing or what.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, I don't know what he's saying, but I'm pretty sure it's about voting for Bernie Sanders in 2028.
Because he'll absolutely still be alive then.
Yeah, and he called in the other day. We did a special episode for our paywall members. Maybe we'll leak a phone call or two, but he called in, and we had a very, very interesting discussion, which is why y'all should donate to Obscene Podzine. Be a contributor.
Yeah, we might have to throw one of those in there in this episode just for a little taste, just the tip, you know. Of our premium content over there. Obscene.rocks/donate if you want to join the paywall. We've been slack about getting content in there, but we're working on it. And this latest thing we did, we like it. We like it a lot. We want to do more of that for you people who pay.
Yeah, we will. It's been rough, you know, we're getting over the winter and whatnot, and getting our rig together, our travel rig, so hopefully we can meet up with y'all and bring this Obscene Record Club how we want it, fucking IRL, baby. We need a coalition of Bernie, bro, musician, fucking Wignat, coalition of Negresses, the whole deal.
Now that's a band name right there. The Coalition of Negresses.
Yeah, that's much better than that terrible racist band, Nigger with a Hard R, which we are completely against.
Yeah, they're terrible people. Do not look them up.
We might have to end with one of their songs just to show you how terrible they are.
That meth is fucking screaming in my fucking ears right now.
Like what, Reed Siege? Because that's pretty Wignar. That's shredding the Wignar.
Incredibly.
Shredding the Wignar, bro.
Did you guys hear about... So, have you guys heard how the Negro Terror guy, he died, so we're not going to get all those shitty screwdriver covers now?
No, I did not hear about that.
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Come on, guys. You're disappointing me. Look up Negro Terror, Voice of Memphis.
Yeah, I got to be honest. When we were briefly into the white identity movement, which we're totally, totally against now that we're Bernie Bros. But when we were briefly
we hate white people.
In that brief time, though, people were very surprised that we had no idea of their music. You know, so at some point we're going to have someone, an expert on the show, to really give us the rundown on the WN music scene.
Yeah, it's surprising how I don't know, like goddamn Reviler.
Yeah, Reviler, the
genderqueer,
the genderqueer Obscene listener knows more about Nazi music than us.
Yeah. Ooh,
I like this.
I like those thumpy drums.
Is everybody a Negro in this band?
Yes.
Wow.
That guy is cool. That's a cool old Negro.
And he wanted to do screwdriver covers? Is that what you're getting at?
That's all he did. That's what he got popular over.
Wow. That's funny.
That's good fucking optics right there. I'll give him that.
You gotta remember, he's from Memphis of all places. It's not a whole lot of people.
Yeah, Memphis, that's a hell of a place.
Never, no one's ever like Memphis, you know, that really white place.
He's playing a Gretsch.
Yep.
Black man's doing something right. A nice fucking like pearl milky white kind of Gretsch too.
I like this mix. Mixed quite well.
It looks like they're using FTP monitors at that show too. The worst thing about these Negroes is that guitar player's got the fucking Flying V guitar. I don't know if it's a BC Rich or not, but those are generally terrible.
Looks like a Hamer or something.
Oh, it's got the weird looking fucking albino Negro at the end too. If they're fucking doing it right. Oh, triple parentheses, nice.
Yeah, that like, damn.
These guys are Antifa coons.
Yeah, I bet.
Screwdriver is the guy that started, Ian Donald Stewart, Ian Stewart was the guy who started the skinhead movement. So they're making a mockery of his music. And I find it funny that they finally get popular and a year later, the guy probably died of a heart attack. You guys saw how large that jigaboo was?
Yeah. He didn't look healthy.
No. No, especially playing like that, singing like that. Yeah, you're going to have a fucking heart attack. But that guy's like a... How many Big Macs do you think that dude shoved up his asshole every day? It's
27. 27.
So they were making fun of it? I thought they were like legit... No.
They were trying to make fun of it, but they did the song justice. So I'm really confused on what they were trying to do, because they're like, haha, see, black people can cover white power songs, but yeah, at the same time, they did it well.
Yeah.
So I'm like,
it's kind of not really, they're just promoting at that point. They're just like, hey, here's a cool song, man.
Yeah. Let's get to some of our voicemails here. I don't think we hit them yet.
Yeah, all right. We have another one from the Telegram group, which I need to get to here. If I can find it again. This is the problem with the Telegram group. This is why y'all should DM the robot. Let me see here. Where is you got some kind of woo woo or something?
I don't have the woo woo. God damn it!
Anything.
I wanted
to search for this voicemail here.
I've wanted to use the woo woo several times in this episode, and I don't have fucking access to it, you know, because of reasons. I think it's a black man's fault, personally, but that's just my opinion.
What the white man calls him. What are you turning into, some kind of feminist?
That's right.
Let me see.
That's right.
Fuck.
Could always do a voicemail too.
Yeah, I'll do that while I look for your audio message there, buddy. I'm trying to remember your username.
Yeah, y'all got to hit the friendly robot up. At some point, we're gonna stop searching around for things in the Telegram group.
In fact, I might even end up renaming the account of the friendly robot just friendly robot, so that it makes more sense when we refer to the friendly robot.
Yeah, because our Telegram group, we love you guys, but you're clearly all Somalians with 67 IQs, right?
Definitely high time preference.
We have the most Somalianist fucking Telegram group on the internet, and we should be subsidized by the American government, I think, right? Doesn't that qualify us?
Yeah, I've never, like, those goddamn defense million people ever.
Yeah, at least the European government should give us money.
Okay. Well, they might want to distribute those shekels. Give some to me then. The FBI already promised me money, and they didn't pay up.
You heard it. Yeah, you heard it first. FBI informant, right here. Obscene Podzine.
Yep. Yeah, it's what we do. We inform the FBI. We like people who inform the FBI. I think everybody should just. That's all the Obscene Podzine is just an open letter.
Bro,
hey,
bro.
Hey, feds.
FBI informant nationalism is how we fucking roll, okay?
Snitch nationalism, bro.
How are we going to win? How are we going to win, guys? We'll just take over the FBI by telling them everything we do.
That'll work.
Yep. All right, I'm going to play this voicemail here. Long one.
Hey, fellas. Thanks for playing the last recommendation there, Tabula Rasa. You know, it was a really good sounding bit there. It does kind of look like one of them, multiracial, commie revolution sort of songs. But I think we ought to adopt those optics for ourselves. Maybe with less brown, you know, get a little bit used to doing and not doing terrors, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, but just reminded me, I checked out that show, listened to the whole thing. Usually, I'll be listening to the pod zines and I'll kind of zone out because I'm doing something. But, man, you guys, it's amazing comedy. All of you are very talented. I wish I was one of them artistic types, you know, with the wig nasty and all that, with the Bernie, with the siege Bernie burning everything. It's like world peace-esque, and you guys keep doing what you're doing for sure. Got another one for you. Reality Dream 3 by Riverside. Thanks a lot, fellas.
You got it, buddy. Reality Dream 3. All
and
right.
That's Roman from who used to be Harold Vero. How do you? I never could pronounce that.
Hora Vero. Is he still? I don't know.
I don't know, but
I haven't been in touch with anybody's shows in the last period here. It's barely in touch with the pod scene.
Yeah, right.
Whoa,
but just so you know, Roman, you're talented as well. I enjoyed the program when it was on.
Yeah, you wrote some pretty epic speeches.
Oh yeah, there. Big time.
Your little bits, prepared bits.
Little monologues.
Yeah, good shit. Speaking of, if anybody wants to do some writing for obscene.rocks or any kind of content, really, if you are any kind of content producer and want just a little bit of amplification and like what we do, send it over here.
Yeah, what's up?
Can I make a porno and put it on your site? Is that wig nasty enough?
It depends on the porno.
Only furries, right? I think that's the only thing we approve of.
Only furries and yentas. But if it involves a yenta, we're fine with that. You know, yentas and black men, that's what I'm all about these days.
That's prime pornography. Every yenta needs a big nigger dick.
It's true. But, no blondes. We have a strict no blonde policy, unless it's a yenta with dyed hair.
Okay. What about ginger?
Well, there are plenty of yenta gingers, so that's just fine.
We throw the gingers in the pit.
And Irish are okay, too. You know, you can throw some Irish chicks.
Frankie's going to get so pissed off listening to this episode.
Oh, yeah. Don't tell Frankie. Hashtag don't tell Frankie.
Well, we already mixed, like, rich Anglos and lowly Irish, and we came up with the southern population. Are you sure we want the southern population everywhere?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't know about that.
Is this one of Roman's like epic fucking epic long songs that he's so
I mean, this is pretty epic.
Oh no, that ain't too bad.
Oh, it's 5 minutes. It's about half the length of the usual.
Yeah.
Of the usual Roman.
Roman used to take up a quarter of the podzine.
Yeah. Yeah, a good quarter too.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not like it's a nonstop like I don't know, tranny dance loop.
Oh, I was gonna say, what was that? That really, really terrible one. This is how we Jew it. And
no, this is how we Jew it was actually a good song, and very red pilling.
It was that one Reviler did with all the faggots.
Yeah.
I still haven't forgiven him for that.
Yeah, it was. A lot of that was the boringness level. Like, once you get into your third chorus of butt fucking, of just anal.
Hey, hashtag women have butts too, okay?
You Sam Hyde people out there, you know.
Yeah, everybody seems to be blaming Sam Hyde for all of Tom Petty's terrorist attacks, and it's
I know, it's getting irritating.
Ooh, this is nice.
That came out of nowhere, too.
Yeah.
It was all chill for 3 minutes.
False sense of security.
Yep, that's how they do it.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Very nice. Good production, too. Quality.
I really dig this song. It's a very epic song.
Oh, yeah. All instrumental, too. No faggot fucking Perry Farrell. Or what? Bronstein? Was that his name? No, that's
Bernstein.
Bernstein. Bronstein was
Trotsky.
What's his name? Trotsky, yeah, it was Bronstein.
Yeah.
Trotsky, Perry Farrell. Well, who is the difference?
It's literally the same guy. Dude, like, I just listened to the Terry Pratchett book, Pyramids. Any of you who's into time and space needs to read the Terry Pratchett book, Pyramids.
Pyramids? Is that some We Was Kang shit or what?
No, it's better. It's some time and space, bro. Any of you Hitchhiker's Guide types.
Ooh, yeah.
That was a good fucking ending, too. Yeah. That was good shit.
Yeah.
Thank you, Roman. I watch that show a lot. To be honest.
Oh, yeah. Have you ever read the books? I think there's like five of them.
I have not. No, yep. I'm one of those dweebs. Like, they're I've never read The Lord of the Rings either.
Oh, dude. You can get all those in audiobook form and just like be at work fucking jamming that shit.
Yeah, it's much easier than trying to, especially Lord of the Rings. Like,
oh, yeah.
I read through the actual book reading once. In my life, I listened to it a bunch, but it's hard to actually sit down and read shit.
I take that back. When I was a third grader, I actually read 3/4 through the first book of Lord of the Rings.
Hell yeah.
I was one of those dweeb kids. I fully admit that.
Yep, one of those
so
dweeb
was Arnold.
Kids who reads.
Yeah. I actually read all the Harry Potters by the time that I was 12.
Yeah.
And you're still not a commie.
I know. Yeah. Actually, I think Harry Potter is an inherently very Nazi-esque thing because the Muggles know where they belong. Okay.
There is a definite segregation rule. It's not like the whole idea isn't about integration.
Slytherin nationalism.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, think about it. Even when you see the pictures in their movies, even though they have diversity, the diversity is always by other diversity. See?
I got to tell you, though, I know that's kind of our generational thing, but if I fucking cruise Tinder one more time and see some stupid thought who said she went to Hogwarts, I'm going to fucking unload in Minecraft with due process.
Oh, no, dude.
I unload in her butthole. Yes. Hashtag women have butts, too.
Yes, exactly.
When normally they'll have, like, daddy issues or they'll hate their dad, and that's when you can go in for the kill. Turn them racist and then drop them, and then they'll be racist the rest of their lives.
That's sound advice, brother.
You heard it here first, Pod Zeners. let me see.
What's your guys' feelings on Sunny in Philadelphia?
On what?
On Sunny in Philadelphia. It's always sunny.
It's like Seinfeld,
but for Irish people.
Yeah, but Goyish, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Goyish Seinfeld. There's only three shows I watch, and that is South Park, Sunny in Philadelphia, and the occasional Futurama episode. It's the only TV I've watched since I was fucking 17.
Futurama's good shit.
Yeah, Futurama. Just add King of the Hill and
King of the Hill is the best. Hank Hill is a fucking American hero, bro.
In fact, Hank Hill called in on our 420 episode, which we're going to play.
Hello there, gentlemen.
Oh my God, we got caller. A new caller here. Who is this?
Oh, hi there. This is Hank Hill of Arlen, Texas. I sell propane and propane accessories, and I had a TV show.
I fucking love propane, dude. It's a clean burning fuel, right?
Oh, yes, sir. There are actually three different kinds. I could go on for 45 minutes about each if you prefer.
No, don't you have something to sing for us or something? I'd rather we're a music network, man. We don't want to hear about propane, though we respect.
Well, we respect propane, and we will happily we support everything you do, Mr. Hill. Yeah, we think.
Oh, thank you.
If you were running for office, we would even consider voting for you above Bernie. But we understand you're busy with your whore
Peggy,
of a niece,
Bobby,
and all that shit. So and Tom Petty,
who's dead now? I hear.
Yes.
Yeah. Well. I don't know. I mean, there are some conspiracy nut jobs out there that say that we were never real people and were just some creation by Mike Judge or something. I never heard of no Mike Judge. I tell you what, maybe he wants to look into Elliot Spitzer, do his job right. But anyway, you know, back when we were on TV, I got to tell you, boys, things were a lot simpler and a lot better in this country. I'm not much of a political guy, and I'd rather stay that way. But I just want to say the left and the right are horribly divided. You know, Luann joined Antifa recently?
Oh, God.
Pretty terrible.
I can't say I'm too surprised, but...
Yeah, she got the milkers.
Really. And, you know, Con Jr.'s now living as a... But what do they call that, Peggy? A trans man? Or STM? I don't know what the hell that is, but I tell you what, I don't know what they put on driver's licenses these days.
Yeah, I'm sure that must have broken Bobby up there. I mean, he had that yellow fever pretty hard.
Oh, yeah. Con Sr. himself ended up in a goddamn mental institute because of it, ranting about RuPaul's Drag Race and the trannies taking over, and took himself a goddamn AR-15 into the... well, I don't want to go too much into that for legal reasons.
Yeah, we don't want to know about that.
How about Bill? How's Bill doing?
Shalom, FBI.
Is Bill all right?
Yeah, Bill's doing fine. Bill's still visiting hot little Asian hookers here and there and whatnot. And, you know, he remembers his names most, or his names, I should say, because, you know, the split personalities. But he's doing okay. He remembers how to tie his shoes and wipe his keister most days and whatnot. Everyone's doing well, though. I do appreciate you asking. How are you boys doing?
We're doing great.
We're doing great. I've been enjoying propane all week, and... what would life be without propane?
Exactly. We'd be excuse my language, but we'd be using crappy charcoal and whatnot.
I wanted to consult with you, a propane expert, about this, but don't you think that places, the underdeveloped countries like Africa, would do so much better if only they could convert over to a clean burning fuel like propane? Like, this might solve Africa's problems.
I mean, I don't know much about that. You know, I'm not a racist man myself, and I like to think we're all just one human race, but, you know, you'd have to ask Gavin McInnes or whatever his name is, because he was talking about burning the Africans being low IQ and burning feces next to their own huts or something on Joe Rogan. I heard he got himself quite a quipping for that. Well, I'm going to get off of here, but I found out about the obscene through Bobbit, and if you boys ever need propane or propane accessories, you know where to call, and Ladybird says hello to your dogs there.
Oh, oh, Ladybird.
Ladybird is so cute.
Good old girl. Yes,
she's about 30 now, which is kind of against biology, but whatever. Well, you boys take care. I'll see you later.
Yeah, thanks, Hank Hill. Thank you, Hank. Hope you start donating to us.
Right there. Right there. We just played it. Let me see here. That whole Hank Hill call got me distracted. Now I'm thinking about that sweet propane. We got another voicemail here.
Obscene. This is a song that's so bad you might enjoy it. It's called "Please Stop Calling Me Gay" by Pink Guy.
Damn.
Enjoy.
Hey. Damn.
Chad heard. Heard him.
Chad heard his daddy.
Yep.
Jim. Jim.
Hey. Hey. Chad.
Jim, that's enough, boy. I see the niggers outside.
Do you hear the blaring rap music, too?
Well, where one comes, the other follows.
Oh, true.
All right, let's check out this gay song.
Hey, shut up. Damn it, dog. Jam, why did you do that?
They get set off. Yeah, there's like a thing.
Hey. It took him a minute, too. I'm surprised, but now he's not about to stop. All right.
Ooh.
I like this album cover.
Stop calling me gay. I
Pink guy.
Willie in high school once, and it was just a little mistake.
So oh, dude, this is this got Reviler all over it.
I love vagina, and I love to touch that pussy. I kissed you girls before.
Him and Donald Trump.
Really good, because they were women and not men. I'm not gay. Penises are for faggots. Penises are for gays.
This is great.
Penises are disgusting.
This is great production.
Not too bad.
I love to have sex.
Ooh.
With women.
Ooh.
With big breasts.
Imagine and being in some nigger car with bumping this shit, just annoying all the white neighbors. Be great.
Yeah, it's so fucking simple too.
It blows hard though. This is totally gay, Joe. You are hurting my feelings. Please stop calling me gay.
Make this clear, because I do not lick willies. I went into your
room,
and I touched my mother's boob, because I'm not gay. See me licking that pussy. It feels really good, and it feels really gushy. I do not have.
Oh no.
But I swear I've touched a pussy. I'd like to have sex with cunts. I'd like to have sex with slits. I'd like to have sex with coin slots. Not fucking dicks. If I had sex with a dick, that would make your point valid. But I'm fucking that pussy.
Did fucking Dave from New York make this fucking track?
I think so.
It doesn't say anything about hair down there, so I don't know.
It does sound as if you took a Dave from New York rant and just put music to it.
So please stop calling me gay.
Well, yeah, thank you, whoever you are. We can only assume about you.
Yeah, right.
If I ever meet a man, I'm going to call him gay.
All right, Pink Man.
Pink Man.
No, no, yeah. I'm talking about the guy that called it in.
The caller. We always
he probably is. He probably is Pink Man. We assume that whoever calls in and requests something is the dude who made it. If we haven't heard of them before, like, you know, if they request something like AC/DC, we were probably sure that it isn't AC/DC requesting it, but...
It is probably Bon Scott. He listens all the time, right? He's dead.
But we also, we don't really play... We got one request for AC/DC, and that was Paul Nealon.
Yeah, yeah.
Wait,
yeah,
Paul Nealon.
Yeah, he requested AC/DC, and we were like, we kind of made fun of him for a while, and then he stopped calling, and it's, hopefully we didn't piss him off. But
yeah, yeah,
we're like fucking boomer.
Yeah, well, I don't know if he's hip to the whole Bernie thing.
Yeah.
So let's play this last voicemail, and then move on here.
We nastified, nigga, gangstified, nigga, putrefied, nigga, sanctified, nigga. Yeah, 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 y'all niggas little motherfucking crack-ass niggas keeping it weak, nasty and shit, nigga. You keeping it nasty, nasty with your motherfucking 1488. Get it straight, nigga. Don't play your hate. Fuck more faggot-ass niggas. Man, I won't hear that motherfucking Slim Anus by ICP, nigga, cuz. Motherfucking Slim Anus, nigga. Motherfucking Slim Anus. What? Keeping it nasty for the motherfucking 14 girls.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, this is ICP and Twisted.
Hey, is that all? Is that all of the? Because there were three that I saw
Eminem,
when I went deleting.
You
want to
diss us? You want to diss the same Clown Posse and Twisted?
That's the last one we got.
Remix from us to you. This is the truth about Slim Anus.
Hi kids, do you like anus? I let Dr. Redfield on my butt for a chance to be famous. Wanna copy me like I did? Yeah. Try Sid, get your butt pumped out like I did. No. My brain's dead weight. I'm trying to get my head straight, but I can't figure out
which Backstreet Boy I wanna impregnate.
Dr. Dre said,
Slim Shady, you a cutie.
Uh-huh.
I'll give you a deal, let me up in that booty.
Okay. 12, I felt like I'm someone else, cause I hung my original self from the top bunk with a belt.
Yep.
Got pissed off and ripped Pamela Lee's tits off. She don't know how to do Tommy Lee. I'd suck his dick off. My anus, it gets tapped on. My anus, excuse me. My anus, every now and then gets plugged up. My anus, can I have it? My anus is occasionally reamed on. My anus,
oh God.
My anus, what? My anus.
This is an especially degenerate episode of Obscene Podzine.
Oh no, I told you. We're going down as
wig nasty, bro. Wig nasty. We have shredding the wignar. Shredding the wignar.
And I tried to fill his
neck up. Extraterrestrial, running over pedestrians in a spaceship while they screaming at me. Let's just be friends! 99% of my life I was lied to.
I just found out my mom screws more guys than I do.
Damn. I told her I'd grow up to be a famous rapper.
Damn.
She met Biden Jay, I couldn't believe it when he slapped her.
You know you blew up when the women rush your stands
and try to touch your hands, but I need me a man.
This guy, White Castle, asked for my autograph, so I signed it. Dear Dave, thanks for the support.
Nice ass.
Oh. Hi! My name is... Excuse me. They call me the pork plunger. My name is.
What?
My name is.
Excuse me.
The itch itcher.
My name is.
I'm on a radio wonder boys. They call me the butt itcher.
My name is.
What?
My name is.
I've been called Greg Butt Boy. Stop the tape. This kid needs to be locked away.
Get him.
Dr. Dre, don't just stand there. Operate.
I'm filling my balls and butt cheeks. Anal lube got my ass. For weeks, stick your manhood between my cheeks.
Good production, I guess. Sounds like they just used the tracks, really.
Yep. I don't know, the snare sounds a little different, but I could just be thinking of the Moon Man version. But, which also used...
Oh, yeah. Oh, what was it? Oh, fuck.
Get behind me, Shady, and grab me by my head.
Moon Man or something like that, right?
KKKKK Moon Man.
Oh, yeah.
Have you seen my spread in gay ass porno, man? Hi, my anus. My anus.
All right, do we have it here? Oh.
Wow, we cut off a song. We generally don't. Oh, there,
Nope, it's not there.
It's not on YouTube.
Damn.
Oh, I wonder anymore.
I got a song request now. I was thinking, why don't we do Haystack Car Full of White Boys?
That sounds entertaining.
It's time to step out on the scene, raise some hell. Rockets up icicles, can't you tell?
Can't even one of those songs I know word for word.
Step out the backseat of a 7-8 Chevelle. Club wasn't jumping, so we had to bail. Finna check out the next spot. My click is about to wreck shop. We don't dance, we just pop. You run up, you get dropped. Parking lot.
That synth bass.
Oh, yeah.
You know the steelo. Bloods in the sub.
Sounds like tuned 808s.
There's no doubt.
Yeah, it ain't too bad.
I think this only came out like 99, 2000, something like that.
Huh.
This guy actually had dealings with Scared Knight, right? What's his name? I think my dog just got this. Yeah, the guy that hung a vanilla ice out the window.
Yeah, I can't hear you well enough over the music, the way this is set up.
Dispatch, we've got a visual on the... It's on for the
night, boy. Car full of white boys.
Boom, boom. Turned out second half in a big body bitch. Mean mugging tails, heads bobbing up and down. Hollin' south side out the window, my people don't fuck around. It's like they looking for a reason to straight climb. When we get gone on it, doing it straight crime. Sounds like a timpani sample there. Boom, boom. All cars
be on the lookout for a car full of cock. Oh, yeah, that's timpani as fuck. Tight, we could pass for A. So if they pull us over, play like you don't speak English. Pass some pretty gal. I told my boy to slow. He does look kind of Asian in that picture, right? We
didn't get no play. I thought Mexican.
Are you crazy? I'm real with the crows. I ain't about to front. Man, we out of blunts. Pull over, folks.
Ooh.
Yeah, this is good shit.
Yeah, I'll have to remember Haystack.
Stop this Circle K, got well produced. Smoke one, now we feeling
like something to eat, man. Yeah, that timpani is fucking killer. I guess we'll go to makes it
2000. The bomb shit, toast with jelly and jam. Hash browns covered with cheese, chili and ham. The awful waffle was packed, but I'm not going to Crystal's. I'll be damned if I gotta go in here and eat with a pimp. Yeah, only thing I'd do is compress those vocals a little more. Place my order, ate my food, then walked about tastefully, of course. Got in the car, placed
the blunt from out the ashtray. Yeah, I like the mix, the vocal mix, though, aside from that.
The vocal production, yeah. Couldn't wait, because when my body hit the brakes, it was like, it's on for the night, boy. Like that, just,
yeah. It's on for the night, boy.
And that's doubled too. The car full of white boys is doubled.
Yeah, the
one's
the doubling
a little more.
the doubling is very, very well done.
Yep.
Common hip hop practice, but they're on it. You know what I mean? Car full of white boys. Car full of white boys. Car full of white
boys. Car full of white boys. Car full of white boys. Yeah, actually sounds kind of reminiscent of Yellow Wolf.
Yeah.
This guy was before the Yellow Wolf. So I have to dip out in like the next 10 minutes. So I got one more song.
Sounds good.
If you guys want to play it,
let's do it.
Wait, okay. Before you play it, what are you dipping out for? Do you got something going on?
Yeah. My show starts in like a half hour on Kiss Killer on YouTube.
Are you not doing the werewolf thing no more?
The Wolfman's activism and entertainment's kind of slowed down because I've had people bail and I'm not talking. I just can't about that.
Shit.
Yeah. So I'll have to catch your new show. But if you want to plug it real quick, I know you just did, but maybe not in the robotic voice here.
Yeah. Yeah, what was that again?
Come on.
Yep. Yeah, it's the robot overlords. I think that the Daily Stormer is telling us we should vote Yang to deal with those robots, but I don't know about that. What was your show?
It's Monday Night Shitpost on Kiz Killer on YouTube.
All right.
Hell yeah.
Cool. Well, give us your last request, and then we'll end it off there, Blake.
Okay, awesome. Jelly Roll and Struggle Falls in the Fall.
Jelly Roll.
This is a protege of Haystack.
Ah.
And that's Waylon Jennings' grandkid.
Huh.
Oh no, really?
Baby, Struggle Jennings.
Well, please love me now.
Looking all post-op Malone.
Post-op Malone.
Gross Maloney.
Gross Maloney. If I did you wrong
before, I won't do you wrong no more. It's all I've ever known.
I wonder what Waylon would think of this.
Baby, who's gonna catch you when you fall? When you really need them, who's the one that you can call? I don't give a fuck about it, you can have it all. Cause the leaves only fall in the fall. Yeah, they fall.
I like how all the high ends cut out of that drinking liquor. Some of my sins kick. House on fire, can't lead a kitchen. Yeah. How committed motherfuckers can't see the vision. Meanwhile, I'm soaked in even gasoline. Here, the game's up and down like a trampoline. It's still, please understand, if you shake the tree, you gotta deal with the low pass filtered like a motherfucker. Man, my life had tragedy, so they taught me something about agony. How to see a lot of shit go. Like the high end of that kick sound is like at 1K. You know, 150. Coming with the sunshine, but forgive me for the times I was blinded from the night that I thought I was flying. Till you find out that you're falling and nobody seems to care. Say, Father God, I forgive him now, cause even demons need a prayer. And I changed my life, I swear. Through the hard times, still right there. Fuck shit, I did my share, but the darkness over and not prepared. Baby, if you love me.
The darkness, the band?
Well, please love me now. Baby, if you love me.
I don't understand how. I mean, I know some people use the front grip on their ARs, but, I don't know. I don't understand. I don't think I have the control over the rifle holding it that way. I prefer to have it up, you know, up on the rail and the grip the barrel personally, but I guess to each their own. When you really need them, who's the one that you can call? I don't give a fuck about it. You can have it all. Cause the leaves only fall and fall. Yeah, they fall, they fall. We fell in love under a full moon to the sound of howling big dogs.
Early morning gunfire, blinded by the thick fog. No way out, I only see a way in. I'm looking for the wind, follow my heart, never a trend. No fear where I've been, cause I'm still good at my worst.
Surviving. That's a big motherfucker, bro.
I like his pocket, his vocal pocket, which is so behind the beat.
Yep,
and smooth.
Getting out of tragedy, no casualties. Jack's telling a strategy.
He's sitting in a walk-in. He's in a walk-in cooler there, and I don't know if I was filming that, I'd turn that fucking walk-in cooler off, especially wearing that little cut-off shirt like that.
He wants the nips to pop through though, just like bam. Because hey man, more lighting on the nips.
Yep. More up lighting on the nips, right?
If I did you wrong before, I won't do you wrong no more.
Who's this bass black guy?
It's all I know.
And this Latino.
It's all I know. It's all I know. Baby, who's gonna catch you when you
it's all I know. You really need nobody
that you can call. I don't give a fuck about
all that fiddle.
He's chest hitting his chest like in fear, like Marky Mark in Fear. Love that scene.
So is it good? Did he do his grandpa proud? He was the guy in the freezer.
He did his grandpa something. All right, Obzine Podziners. We apologize for the robot overlord who has been trying to dam our operation here, but we're definitely thankful to have Blake here, and you should catch him on his show, and
yes,
donate to him and to us.
Give him shekels, give us shekels, give everybody who's cool your shekels.
You get a car, you get a car. And I want a fucking car.
Give us cars.
Everyone likes to talk about karma, but it's not willing to do anything good for other people. See?
It's true.
Yeah.
It's true.
It's not right.
That's right.
Yes, yes, Ace Ventura. All right, fellas. That's That's about as much of the wig-nar that I can handle. I am so pitted, bro.
Pitted.
I am so pitted. Fucking pitted.
Good night.
Do you even, like, read Siege, bruh?